The race to 5G is on, and the battle for talent is getting fierce. Welcome to 5G Talent Talk with Carrie Charles, a podcast dedicated to helping you face the future workforce head on. Navigate this challenging talent landscape with innovative strategies to attract, retain, and engage people in this new world of work, only here on 5G Talent Talk with Carrie Charles, CEO of Broadstaff Talent Solutions.
Welcome to 5G Talent Talk. I'm Carrie Charles, your host, and I'm really glad that you are here with me today. We have an exciting episode for you. I think every episode is exciting. I'm especially looking forward to this one. I have with me Serghei Busmachiu. He is the CEO of Utilities One. Serghei, thank you for coming on the show today.
Hi, thank you. Thanks for having me at the show. I'm very excited to be here.
Yes, yes. I can't wait to get into this. Serghei, I want to know about your past and how you got into this industry and how you started, because I think it's so inspirational.
I appreciate that. So I think I'll get going. So I'll start with the real beginning, with my humble beginning in the United States of America. Myself, I'm originally from the Republic of Moldova, and I immigrated in the United States in 2013 for looking for a better life. And I was going, you know, through multiple jobs myself, you know, trying to build a new life here. And, you know, I started my first job at the Johnny Rockets as a dishwasher. And after that, I worked for a couple months there. And after that, I was looking for next job. And actually, I end up in Alaska selling ice, which is, it's funny and crazy in the same time, but that's true.
So wait, people really do that? There's yeah. People who sell ice in Alaska, and you were one of them.
Yeah, and actually, it's pretty hot during the summer in Alaska, and it's a pretty lucrative business. At some point, I would buy that business when I want to retire and spend the life in Alaska, because it's a beautiful place out there. And, you know, going through multiple jobs, had, you know, construction jobs, you know, moving jobs and so on, but it really turned into the different path of my career when in 2014, a friend of mine ended up to move in Chicago, and he asked me to come and move with him, and maybe we start a new future out there and build a new future. And we move. I came to his place, but he didn't have internet at that time, and I was googling what's the internet provider out there, and I called Comcast, and Comcast sent in our way a technician, and that technician, fortunately, was from next country, from Ukraine, and we spoke the same language. And I asked him the details about the job itself, and he explained all those details, and I was excited and intrigued about that opportunity. And you know, next thing, you know, I contacted his employer, which was a contractor for Comcast at that time. And I went to their facility for training, and I spoke about the job details, and that's how I end up, you know, in 2014 being a cable tech. And from there, you know, it was a great movement, because, you know, I started learning, you know, what's a real customer satisfaction is. I learned about how should customer to be treated. And many times I actually went an extra mile supporting the clients of Comcast, and, you know, the clients that was in front of me. And that's how I learned, you know, the cable industry. And that's how I really started understanding and seeing a bright future there. And, you know, working a couple years in the industry, that's how I kind of founded Utilities One.
And now you are a successful founder and entrepreneur, and your journey is just fantastic. Who is Utilities One? So tell a little bit more about the story of maybe how it was founded, or why, what you do, who you serve.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Utilities One, like I said, it was founded in 2016 through fulfillment business. And as I said, you know, I started myself as a cable technician. I understood the industry. And actually, you know, I made a lot of friends and a lot of good connections through the industry. I brought a lot of people and colleagues that today are working with me, and I trained them as a technician, and they kind of learned, you know, about the cable industry. And from there, you know, we started the fulfillment business. That means installation and repair that provides the last mile service. And simultaneously, you know, 2 or 3 years after we started the fulfillment business, we saw a lot of demand into the build on the construction engineering part. And I was excited about, you know, learning new stuff and about bringing the new challenges to myself and to the company and so on. And that's how around 2018-2019 we started the construction division for telecom, and we also developed a year or two later the engineering division. And simultaneously we develop our wireless division as well. That, you know, we at that time there was a huge peak of 5G rollout, and there was a lot of work, and through our, you know, community and through our connection, we knew a lot of people that are doing, you know, tower climbers, small cell installations, and we end up doing the wireless world as well. And today, you know, in the telecom space itself, for the company, it's we're a nationwide company. We have we're covering about 20 states from 50 states of the United States. And we provide turnkey services for turnkey service from the planning, design, engineering, construction, and last mile installation. And lately, we develop ourselves not only into the telecom business and the wireless business. I mean, the wireline and wireless. You know, we develop other industries that. We saw that are upcoming. They're not as big as today as the telecom business, but they also play a big role for our future and the way where we tell it moves. And those are industries, our power delivery industry. We have the renewable energy industry, and now lately we got into the water services industry.
So what makes Utilities One really stand out in the marketplace? I'd like for you to discuss what you mentioned to me, that you provide unicorn service. And I'd love to know, what does unicorn service look like?
So, you know, Utilities One is obviously, you know, I believe, you know, that the volume that and the growth that stays behind, you know, obviously we deliver a much quality and reliability and going beyond of our client expectation. But you know, the main thing, you know, you get, you know, a lot of great companies out there that are really good construction companies, really good engineering companies, really good fulfillment companies, but you don't really get the company that does a really, really great, that provides that great of a service that Utilities One provides at every single part of the service. You know, we take each service as a priority, and we believe, you know, our customer, that customer expectation is the top number one priority. And by going, you know, what makes us as a unicorn, I believe, you know, putting all these services combined, and also, you know, the way we position in the market, we always under promise and over delivering. So that's what really, I think, makes us as a unicorn and into the business today. And plus a lot of great other things that we bring to the partners and to our clients. I believe you really see us differentiated.
You have achieved unbelievable growth in such a short period of time. How many employees do you have now?
So the organization itself, we're sizing over 3,000 employees today.
Wow. So what do you think contributed to such rapid growth?
Well, obviously, you know, to hold this growth, it played a major, the industry that I chose, you know, we see a lot of peaking into the fiber telecom, building fiber on all the rural areas. But, you know, obviously, you know, we couldn't deny that the great people that we brought into business, you know, I was lucky enough to bring a great COO, Jody Miller, that brought a lot of great leaders with himself. And that was helpful, you know, to bring the company to the next level. Because obviously with all this growth, it comes a lot of the demand from the clients, comes a lot of the responsibility from our side that we have to deliver it to our clients. And I believe that the main thing what he helped us and support us to achieve the growth on the short manner of time, it was bringing great team together, putting that great team together, and bringing great leaders that really understood my vision from day one and are real out there making things happen for us and making sure you know, we provide the best quality service to our clients.
Do you think that it really made a difference, you starting as a cable tech, and how you can relate to every single person in your company?
Yes, it does really make a difference because, you know, being starting from the bottom and going all the way up, you know, really comes with a lot of knowledge and going through multiple phases of the company. And, you know, I started the company when, you know, with one or three employees in the beginning, and growing, you know, 3,000 employees, obviously a lot of things change, my responsibility change on day-to-day basis, you know. And since we're growing and adding more talented people, we're adding more positions in the company, more roles in the company, responsible that we didn't have last year. But, you know, because of the growth, we have to be proactive and think about, you know, all the risk being a bigger company, thinking about, you know, other challenges that might come along with being a bigger company. So it really does change. But at the same time, you know, I still remember the days when I was in the beginning, that the way we used to run business. And, you know, at some point, I think we were able to move much faster. But today, because of the being a bigger company, we still move very fast, I believe, comparing to other competitors. But, you know, it's not moving as fast as I wanted. But I believe we're still doing a great job as a business, as overall as a company. And again, you know, it does really help the background that I was a cable tech, and I really know what it means to be out there and what it, you know, just put it that way. I know what it means to working in Florida with 100 degrees in the attic. It's a really tough job.
Yes, it
and
sure
having
is.
Having the customer pressure behind.
Yes, yes. Working in 100 degrees with the customer pressure. There you go.
Yeah. Yeah.
The you know, it's tough too when you're scaling, whether it's scaling fast or just scaling slow, to maintain the culture. Tell me a little bit about the culture at Utilities One. What is it like to work there?
Well, you know, each company, I believe, has their own culture. But, you know, our culture, it's all about hard work and dedication. And myself, I'm coming with the background of mixed martial arts. And it's like never give up, you know, till you get the job done or till you win. Same type of culture we have at Utilities One. And like I always tell to my people and my team, and some of them might not like it, but I always saying that the way, like, look, we're not the smartest people in the room. We might not be the smartest people, but we're going to work out everyone else that is going against us, or that is our competition. And, you know, by working harder than anybody else, you will achieve great things. And we really, you know, it really comes down, you know, to the martial arts, you know. You get very talented sportsmen, and you get, you know, people that are not so talented, but very willing, you know, to put into the work and they're willing to achieve. And that's anything, you know, martial arts, any other sports. It's very similar to the business industry, and it has that competitive mindset that, you know, you have to work to achieve the great things. And obviously you get the same thing as here. You get very, very smart people and that, you know, have a real high IQ, but you get people that are not the smartest, but they put so much into the hard work, and sometimes they beat those smart people.
That Boy, being, you know, you're right about that. I've seen that many times.
Yep. And that's all about our culture, you know, like, you know, we don't strive to be, you know, to bring in the company, be big, you know, somebody with high-level degrees or high-level background, you know, what we strive to bring here, we strive to bring in the business and the organization employees that wants to work hard and wants to achieve it. And that's kind of what stands out about Total's own culture.
Yeah, and I call that grit, right,
what
where I come from. Grit, you know, like I was in the Marines, and that's
okay.
That's what we call it. You know, people who have that grit, because I don't have a college degree, and but boy, you know, have I, you know, worked hard, and, you know, I've got that intensity and that work ethic that really is unmatched. So that makes perfect sense. You've got people, Serghei, that have been with Utilities One for since day one.
Yes.
And your retention rates are exceptional. So I think, what would you attribute that to?
Well, you know, I believe that, you know, each company should have their own way of doing things, like I said, and should have the core value where the business come. Main thing of retention, you know, is I believe it's part of the core value, you know, that we have and the business. And, you know, I really believe those employees that has been day one with me, we really have the same mindset than I do. And, you know, really with years of working hand in hand with me, I believe that transition to them as well. And sometimes I just feel very more tough than I am, you know, and I see very more tough to their teams than I am. And that's what it really, I think, it helped us to have that retention into the business, because I was lucky enough, you know, to find the right people that have the same type of mentality. And that's how we form a great group, because, look, when you get bigger, as I said, you run the business way different, you know. You don't really get involved as much as into the financing, you know. You have just one or two people that you're talking from financing. You don't get too much into the supply chain, you know. You have one or two person talking there. You don't get into the procurement department as much. You don't get too much into program management or as other business, as other parts of the business. You really talk only with those leaders. And by having those leaders with the same mentality, I believe we're able to transmit, you know, the energy and the core value of the company from the beginning and to other employees that are newer to the business. And that's what it really helps. And I believe, you know, we have a great culture at Utilities One, because, you know, everybody sees the growth that we're having, you know, and that inspire even employees, you know, who are in the organization, because we bring the models. For example, you know, I have the fulfillment vice president, Ivan Galkin, that has been with ourselves, you know, since, I believe, since the beginning of 2016. And he started as a tech as myself, and he grew in the company from the supervisor to the manager to the director. Now he's the VP running the division, and he's a great example. We still have pictures that we show to other employees. Look, Ivan at that time, you know, he worked as a cable tech for a couple of years, and he proved himself that he's a great great tech. He takes care about the customer, and that's how we moved role by role. And examples like Ivan, I have multiple examples in the organization that I can give it to you, and, you know, to 5G talks. And I believe it's many of those that, you know, the accounting that is run by Mihaela Poyata, she's been the same way. She started from day one, and she was the only one who doing all whole accounting. Now she has on her team about 40 professionals that are doing the accounting and financing for us. So it's many examples that I can bring, you know, that help to kind of support that retention rate in the organization.
You know, you also have a really strong training program, and you believe in internal training. And I think that's probably another big reason why you have so much growth in the company. So tell me, why do you feel like it's so important? And also, what type of training programs do you have in place?
Well, we don't have any specific training, like looking, you know, by... we don't take any advices, you know, from other other books or leaders or so on. We try to do it the U1 way, and we try to do it our way training. Our main training is when we bring somebody in the organization, we try to challenge them and to the they to the li- kind of push it to the limits. And when the limits breaks, you know, that that's when we start to support him. We really want to see what the, that individual is capable to do it. So that being said, you know, we the way we prioritize and the way we see things on the leadership training is like better shoot for the moon or land among the stars. And that's how kind of we do the training, if that makes sense to you. It's a really, you know, challenging. It's all about challenges. It's all about, you know, every day when I wake up, I challenge myself, you know, and that's what I'm expecting from the other leaders in the organization, to challenge the challenge ourselves and challenge the teams that we're running day to day. And we also, they obviously, you know, with all these challenges, you know, I love to see that people failing, and I love to support the, them to be successful, because without failures, there's no winners. So again, we're coming back to the culture of mixed martial arts, where, you know, you lose, you learn, and you win again. So that's how you get to the next level, just to learn from the defeats, humbling defeats.
What inspires you as a leader? Like, what drives you?
The main thing what drives me as a leader, it's, you know, like I mentioned before, you know, it drives me, you know, day to day, the growth of the company, and drives me, you know, to see that employees that has been with me for many years, from day one, and see them, you know, and remember them from day one, and the way we used to do things, and the way we're running the business, and the way we're doing, things for the company, and you know, it really drives me to see the growth inside of the business, and drives me to the mind that, you know, I was able to change so many lives, and I was able to change, support so many families, and help so many families to put the food on their table. And also, you know, drives me to provide the quality service that you know, helps us, you know, to go at a larger scale. It drives me, you know, to wake up every morning and think, what's the next thing for the utilities one? Where is utilities one gonna move? You know, are we gonna move, you know, more into the power services? Are we moving into the water services? Are we seeing where's the future gonna take? And go and figure out those things. As I said, as you said, you know, being without a college degree, it's all about going out there and kind of start figuring out things, like how you can make those things happen. Because, you know, it's really challenging to go out there and, you know, with no experience, to learn, you know, new industry, to learn the new challenges. And, you know, the most important, to get a chance, you know, to prove yourself in that industry. And I know it's a different industry, but I see a lot of similarity in those, in all the infrastructure industry by end of the day. And like I said prior, you know, through hard work and dedication, you can achieve anything. And to answer your question, my drive and my why today is to build a company that will really make an impact in the industry.
Mm. So let's talk a little bit about the industry, and where do you see the opportunities now, not only in telecom, but also in adjacent verticals?
Yeah, so, I mean, the industry itself, you know, it's industries itself is gonna move different direction, I believe. Today, you know, our focus as a business is a telecom industry, just because, you know, after the COVID, everybody, you know, went and worked in rural areas, and some of them didn't have the connectivity and didn't have the reliable internet out there. We see today a lot of focus into the building the fiber to the rural areas, and support, you know, America build, you know, a great fiber network. But simultaneously, I see the other demands that are coming out there. You know, we have, you know, a huge demand from AI that, you know, obviously will drive, you know, to increase, you know, the build of the power grid, the build of, you know, more smarter power grid, and just improving the power infrastructure. And that obviously we have the power delivery infrastructure division that, you know, we're growing that division, and I see a lot of potential keep growing that division, because, you know, with this AI and the EV charges and many other things coming and infrastructure, I see a huge need for our power grid. And also, let's not forget about the achievement that it's coming from the Biden administration about the carbon pollution free by 2035 and net zero emission by 2050, which that also will drive, you know, a lot of growth on our renewable energy division, where we have capabilities as an EPC, engineering, procurement, and construction for the solar farms, for the wind turbines, and other aspects of energy, of renewable and sustainable energy. And I see a great growth in that division as well. And not the last and the least thing, you know, we started the water division, where, you know, if you take those other parts of the infrastructure, those are more like commodities. You know, this part I see more as a water is a necessity, and we need good water, you know, to drink and to bring in the people's homes and the customers' businesses and so on. And by starting this division this year, we're pretty new to this, but I see a lot of the necessity of a great services and that aspect of the water. And I see a huge potential out there, you know, by building, you know, the new pipelines, the water sewer, and building, you know, installing the water meters to detect, you know, the quality of water and the leakage and so on. So it's I see a huge demand in other parts of the industry beside the telecom in the next couple of years as well. But I just believe today our focus and area of expertise will be the telecom for the next couple of years. But simultaneously start improving and growing bigger the other industries that I mentioned.
Wow. Serghei, I have no doubt that Utilities One is going to be, who knows? I mean, maybe a unicorn billion-dollar company. What are your goals? Well, what is your vision for the future? What do you see at Utilities One becoming in the future?
Well, so the future, you know, obviously is bright, and I believe we're going to overpass $1 billion pretty soon as a business, because, you know, we have great things and great industries that we're working on. And you know, the vision for Utilities One is to be a partner of choice for critical infrastructure, and not only in the United States, but globally, because, you know, today we're working on the huge project with the Department of Reconstruction of Ukraine, that we're going to be a part on the restoration of, you know, it's unfortunate after the war of Russia. But we're in the discussion today that we're going to go out there and build the residential 50,000 residential homes across the Ukraine, and supporting other initiative and the country of Ukraine, and that will really help us, you know, to put our foot, you know, more into the global areas. And we're also looking for other opportunities to develop the business in the South America, and Chile, Peru, Colombia, and other areas that I see that there's also an opportunity in the need. And, you know, the vision for Utilities One is to become a global company of, like I said, a partner of choice for critical infrastructure. So that's where we're moving. And I believe, you know, if we should do a recap of this interview in 2-3 years, and we'll be way, way ahead of the game that we are today. Because we're going to be a different phase.
I have no doubt, Serghei. how can we reach Utilities One and also find out about open jobs that you have?
So, yeah, we have, you know, obviously we have the career and our Utilities One website, and we also have a contact form that you can reach out to us. And also, you know, I could share my personal information if that's needed.
Wonderful. Serghei, this has just been fantastic. Thank you for sharing. And it's just, you're such an inspiration. You inspire me. So I feel like I'm stopping after this interview and going to work and working harder than I've ever worked in my life. So
That's good.
Has been fantastic. Thank you for coming on.
Well, thanks for having me. Have a great day.
You too.
Thank you for listening to another informative episode of 5G Talent Talk, brought to you by RCR Wireless News, Telecom Careers, and Broadstaff Talent Solutions. As we advance into the future, we promise to bring you the resources you need to navigate this ever-changing landscape of 5G to help you attract, retain, and engage people in this new world of work. To access the show notes or leave a review, visit broadstaffglobal.com. Until next time.